I'm Terence McKenna. I knew Leo for the last 5 years of his life. I feel deeply honored to be asked to speak at this occasion. There are many people here, I'm sure, who knew Leo longer and on more intimate terms than I myself did. I felt when I stood near Leo that I stood near a giant. And what the experience of standing near a giant was the experience of the wisest, kindest, gentlest, funniest man that I have ever had the privilege to know. When I first met Leo, I was so impressed by his vitality. After the public meeting at which we met, I cornered him in private and I said, "Leo, I want to ride in your canoe. I don't care where you're going. I just want to be in your canoe." And he said, "You're always welcome in my canoe." And I felt that his saying that to me inducted me into a group of people that I think of as Leo's tribe, Leo's people. And for Leo's tribe, Leo was our chief. He was the secret chief. He had no theory to push. He had no axe to grind. In his chosen field, which was psychology and the healing of the soul, he understood better than anyone I've ever met that it's a matter of letting the psyche grow and flower according to its own rules. You stand present, you stand ready, and then you do as little as possible. And everyone who has ever had Leo sit for them knows that that was exactly how he worked. One of the goals of Leo's life was the search for the perfect high. And he inspired many of us to follow in his footsteps. I trust that he has found that. There was a passage in Rainer Maria Rilke's Letters to a Young Poet that was very important to Leo. He read it to me twice in the space of 6 months, making sure that I understood every word of it. And I'll read it to you now. "Leave to your opinions their own quiet, undisturbed development, which, like all progress, must come from deep within and cannot be pressed or hurried by anything. Everything is gestation and then bringing forth. To let each impression and each germ of a feeling come to completion wholly in itself, in the dark, in the inexpressible, the unconscious, beyond the reach of one's own intelligence, and await with deep humility and patience the birth hour of a new clarity. That alone is living the artist's life, in understanding as in creating. There is here no measuring with time. No year matters, and 10 years are nothing. Being an artist means not reckoning and counting, but ripening. Like the tree which does not force its sap and stands confident in the storms of spring, without the fear that after them may come no summer. It does come. But it comes only to the patient, who are there as though eternity lay before them, so unconcernedly still and wide. I learn it daily, learn it with pain to which I am grateful. patience is everything. Sometimes when Leo would sit with people, they would come out of their reveries and want to talk with him about what they were learning and seeing. And Leo would listen for a few minutes, but he then would always say, "That's fine, that's good, now return to the music." And I think that, I like to think that Leo has now returned to the music. And someday so shall we. And to whatever degree we follow his example, life here and the passage to whatever lies beyond will be made much easier. Leo showed the way because Leo knew the way. And I salute him for that. I say for all of us who were his tribe, goodbye to the secret chief. Goodbye to the man who saw most deeply. It's now for us to do as he would have had us do.